What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another YouTube video. Your boy Booty King. Today's workout, new year, new booty. And I'm gonna show you guys the five most effective exercises you could do at home to grow your whole entire lower body, your legs, your glutes. And today we have a special guest, Lily.
Hi, guys.
Lily, don't be shy. Show them the booty gains. Show them the booty gains, Lily. That's Lily right there. Oh, by the way, her transformation is amazing. I'm gonna post it right here just so you guys see her transformation. It's insane. How much do you weigh right now?
112.
And you, when you, like that before picture, how much do you think you weighed right there?
82 pounds.
Damn, so that's 20 pound difference right there. And it's what? It took you how long?
Three years.
3 years. Okay, so the first workout I'm gonna show you guys is a hip thrust. Now, the two exercises that are really for the glutes are single leg hip thrust and hip thrust. Now, the hip thrust, I would say, is the most effective exercise to grow your glutes, right? But that's something that I would recommend you do at the gym, because you have unlimited weight right there. When you're at home, you might not have as much weight, and the hip thrust might be way too easy. When you do a hip thrust, you're using both your legs, right, to push up your hip. Even though this is the most effective exercise to do at home, because you're able to load the exercise, when you're at home, you might not have that much weight. So this exercise actually becomes too easy. So what I recommend if you're working out at home is you switch out hip thrust to a single leg hip thrust, just like that. So, because when you're at home, you don't have that much weight. The single leg hip thrust is really effective and you feel it with just your body weight. So it's gonna be something that's really effective and you don't need that much weight to make it effective. Once body weight becomes too easy, you start adding up 5 pounds, 10 pounds, 20 pounds, etc. So, you know, hip thrust, single leg hip thrust, they're both effective. But if I had to pick just one for you to do at home to grow your glutes, I would definitely do the single leg hip thrust. Now I'm gonna have Lily do it. I'm gonna explain the form real quick. So, she has her upper back against the couch. And look, one foot on the ground, the other one's gonna be in the air. Right? So when she goes up, she extends her hip all the way up so she's in line, her legs are in line with her body like that, right? And she's pushing off her heels. This is where all the pressure comes from. When you push off the heels, that's what transfers energy from the hamstrings to the glutes. Now go down. Now go up, but don't go all the way up. Okay, so a lot of people do this mistake. They think just by going this high that they're working out their glutes to the full potential, but you're not. You need to do full hip extension. Full hip extension is this. Go up a little higher. Right there. That's full hip extension. So that's when you do this exercise, you want to make sure you're going up all the way to that point. And then you just repeat the movement. Lily's leg glutes are on fire right now. Just like that. All the way down. All the way down to where your glutes almost hit the ground. You want the full stretch. Pull down. Right there, and then boom, you explode up. A lot of beginners are going to struggle to do this exercise. So what I recommend is you start off with the hip thrust. As you build up more glute strength with the hip thrust, then I recommend you move on to the single leg hip thrust, okay? So right there, that's the first exercise I'm gonna recommend for you guys. Number one out of five for the most effective home exercise you can do. Okay, so I just showed you a booty exercise. The next exercise I'm gonna show you is called Romanian lunge, Bulgarian lunge, Bulgarian split squat. You're gonna see a lot of names for this exercise, but the most important thing is that you get the form right. So, Romanian lunges. You're gonna need a chair or a couch or a platform where you could put one leg on top, just like this. Now, if you're a beginner, you're gonna struggle with balance. When you do this exercise, you're gonna find yourself falling. And if that's the case, I recommend you get a chair next to you and you grab onto it to help with the balance. Once you got that figured out, what you wanna do now is you're gonna focus, you're gonna bend both knees, you're gonna go straight down. Right before your knee hits the ground, you push off that front leg, you push off the heel from that front leg, and you go up, okay? And then you repeat the movement, up, okay? The last thing you wanna do is go down where your heel picks up off the ground, just like that. And you're pushing off your toe. That's not what you want in this workout. Or you don't really want that for any exercise. So you go down and up, just like that. All right, Lily, show them the demo. Okay, so she's gonna go down. Right before the knee hits the ground, she goes up. And what you're gonna feel is the legs. So this is a really good exercise for the legs. And you will engage the glutes as well. So since you're using the legs for this exercise, you might not feel the glutes, but trust me, they're being used. But you're gonna feel the legs so much more, which is why you might not feel the glutes. But trust me, you're working the glutes, the legs, with this exercise, just like that. And you wanna aim for like 12 to 16 reps. The reason I recommend a lot of reps when you're doing home exercises is because, you know, a lot of people are limited with the weight. So what you wanna do is, you wanna increase the reps. So once 16 reps is too easy, maybe move on to 20. If you have more weight, then just add weight, keep the reps around 12, 16 reps. But if you don't have more weight, then you're gonna have to increase the reps. By the way, for you guys who are wondering, Lily's outfit is from Rare Fit. If you wanna shop her fit, rarefit.com right here. Click the link, get yourself some new workout clothes. Okay, so remember when I brought up the chair, how you can use a chair when you're doing the lunges on the second exercise I mentioned previous to this. So what you wanna do is you just grab the chair like this and just go down and up. So the third exercise that you can do at home that's really effective, stationary lunges. So similar to the Romanian lunges we did, I would say this is a little easier because you don't have your foot somewhere in the air. This one is similar movement though. You're gonna have a nice distance between your feet. You don't want your feet too close because that's gonna turn into just literally quads. What you wanna do is you wanna also get the glutes, so you bring out your leg a little bit further back. You're gonna bend both knees. Right before your knee hits the ground, you go up. And if you have trouble with the balance, that's why the chair's here. Right, Lily?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's go, Lily. So look, at her form. She has a good distance between her feet. And then all she's doing, literally, she's bending both knees and going straight down. As she goes up, she's pushing off the heel. Very important. So she's gonna get the legs and the glutes, just like that. Super simple, guys. You wanna do like 12, 16 reps. And like I mentioned in the other exercise, if you could increase the weight, do that. If you don't have enough weight to increase the reps. It's called progressive overload, getting stronger throughout time. That's one of the biggest keys to seeing progress. It's not just the exercises, guys. You can't just be thinking like, oh, I'm doing the most effective exercises, I'm gonna see results for sure. No, it doesn't work that way. Progressive overload is key. You have to consistently get stronger throughout time, either adding more weight or adding more reps. If you're not doing that, adding that technique to your workouts, you're not gonna see any results. You have to get stronger throughout time. You have to challenge your body. It's the only way to make your body change. Am I right?
Yeah.
Right or right? So here we got number four, step ups. This is one of the other exercises that's really good for your legs and your glutes. So you're gonna need a platform. Here we got a couch. You're gonna place one foot on the couch. And notice how her whole foot is on the couch, not just a part of her foot, her whole entire foot, because she wants to push off the heels when she goes up. So right here, what you're doing is she's pretty much picking up her leg, right? But she's not really pushing off that foot right here. She's barely pushing off at, if anything, because you know, if you push off this foot too much, then you're not really using this leg to get up. You're pretty much using your momentum. So it's very important that you try to limit the momentum when you're doing this exercise. And you're gonna feel your legs, your quads, your glutes when you're doing this. And you wanna do like 12 to 16 reps when you're doing this exercise. After you're done with the reps, you switch on to the other leg, other side. You know, before we move on to the fifth exercise, she's getting ready for it. She's placing on the ankle bands and ankle straps. Look, even though this is a good routine for you to transform your legs and glutes, you could literally do this routine twice a week. I don't want you guys to think that just because you're doing this routine, you're gonna see results. It literally does not work that way. Like, you still have to be consistent. If you're not consistent, but you're doing these exercises, you're not gonna see results. You have to be consistent. And you also have to, like I mentioned before, you have to get stronger throughout time. It could be really easy for me to just tell you like, okay, you're gonna see results, just do these. Like, no, it doesn't work that way. You still have to be consistent. You still have to push yourself. A lot of it comes down to you. I know you guys wanna know the most effective exercise there is out there, but it's not gonna work if you're not consistent and you're not applying progressive overload and getting stronger throughout time. So, you know, just remember that. Those are the biggest keys right there. Just getting stronger throughout time and being consistent with it.
And food.
And food. You have to eat enough. You have to eat enough protein. Your body requires you to eat enough protein daily. You know, if you need to eat 100 grams, you have to do that consistently with food, protein shakes. Protein shakes help a lot because, you know, eating enough protein with just your food is, it could be really difficult. So protein shakes help with that. And if you guys need protein, onesoulsubs.com. Okay, here we got the fifth exercise. We got donkey. This is to isolate the glutes. Look at her position. She bent this knee, right? Her back is flat. She's kicking back, right? When she kicks back, her leg and body are in line. She's not kicking up too high or anything. She's going just perfect right there. Leg and body in line. And she's gonna feel the glute on this side. After we're done with this side, she's gonna move on to the other. This exercise right here is gonna require a lot of practice because it really is difficult to get the form down right away. But you're gonna isolate the glutes with this. And then move on to the other. All right, guys, real quick, because I almost forgot to do an outro for this video. Make sure you guys apply those techniques that I gave you, you know, be consistent, progressive overload, eat enough protein, and you guys are gonna see results. You know, that's what I know. That's why a lot of you guys watch me. You guys wanna see results. So I'm trying to give you all the tips for you guys to see results. But other than that, thank you guys for watching. And don't forget, pineapple belongs on pizza. You're